Through you, Mr. President, I'd just like to just briefly describe the amendment. The purpose of the portion of the budget bill is simple. As more and more large clinics are being built without any sort of Department of Health approval, this bill creates a demonstration program in the county of the Bronx to allow for a public forum so that the community can have input before such projects are built.
Senator Klein, do you yield?
Yes, Mr. President.
Senator Rivera.
Thank you, Mr. President. Is there a particular reason why the provision only refers to the Bronx and not the rest of the state?
Well, this is an issue that certainly eventually is going to have an impact throughout the state. As many of you know, a lot of hospitals are now sponsoring clinics, ambulatory care programs, because really the future is to have many doctors housed under one roof in these large facilities. Also, it is not profitable for hospitals, as you know, and not very efficient to offer very long hospital stays. So most of these procedures can be done not even having the individual required to stay overnight. So while I agree with the concept of efficiency in healthcare, agree with what a lot of these providers are proposing to sort of streamline healthcare and make it very easy for the patient to obtain services sort of all under one roof, this is something that presently has no oversight by the Department of Health. Certainly locally, this hit home in my district in the community of South Riverdale, where Montefiore, an excellent healthcare provider, decided to put right smack in the middle of a residential community a proposed 11-story ambulatory care center. It may not be considered a hospital by the Department of Health, but certainly it's very, very large, very, very cumbersome, and it caused a community outcry. People are outraged that this large institution is going to be put right in the middle of a residential block, not taken into consideration the density of the neighborhood, not taken into consideration the traffic patterns. They're expecting over 1,000 people a day to come in and out of a roadway on a very narrow block. So I thought it was important that we at least require that the Department of Health really take some community concerns. And so what this would do is allow for a community forum, which would be set by the Department of Health, making sure to get local community board input, having them explain what they're doing about the density, the need, as well as traffic, and then really leaving it up to the Department of Health to either mandate, modify, or disapprove the potential project.
Thank you, Mr. President, if Senator Klein would continue to yield.
Senator Yield?
Yes, Mr. President.
Senator Rivera.
Thank you. So if this is I'm trying to figure out if it's something that is, it is, you mentioned this clinic at Montefiore, or the proposed building that Montefiore is potentially putting up. And while I certainly have been, I'm familiar with some of the stories, this is something that would impact the Bronx as a whole. Is that, so my...
Through you, Mr. President?
So my question through you, Mr. President, so if it's going to impact the Bronx as a whole, what type of impact could it have on other facilities that are potentially attempting to do something, to build one of the three in the categories that are established in this bill?
Mr. President, this would apply to very large facilities. These would have to be facilities that are over three stories in height and over 30,000 square feet. So this is not your little small neighborhood doctor's office. These are very large facilities. And again, I don't think it's too much to ask when anyone is building a project of this size in any community, let alone the Bronx, that they explain to the community and answer some basic questions. What is the impact that this is going to have on the quality of life of the community? How are you going to deal with the traffic? How are you explaining the need for this facility in the community? You know, is there a market? Are there people who need to utilize these services? And again, this in no way gives the Department of Health sort of having to respond to the community as far as it doesn't give the community a veto power. What it really does, pure and simple, is give the community a voice and then allows the Department of Health to really weigh and listen to what the community has to say and act accordingly.
Through you, Mr. President, the Senator Klein will continue to yield.
Senator Klein, do you yield?
Yes, Mr. President.
Senator yields.
Thank you, Mr. President. When I spoke about institutions, I was facilities. I was less referring to the facilities to be built and more referring to the institutions that might be impacted, or plans that might impact, or plans that might be impacted from other institutions, like certainly Montefiore, as we serves both of our constituencies. It serves most constituencies of the Bronx. It's a huge hospital. In the case of St. Barnabas, for example, which is a safety net hospital, which it is actually potentially going to build something like one of these categories, maybe in the plans of doing it. Was there any thought through you, Mr. President, of the impact that it would have, kind of adding another regulatory framework to what these institutions have to go through now? Because it is not, I do not believe that it is as simple as choosing a space and just building something without actually having some other, making sure that the Department of Health actually approves the services that they're going to provide in this new space. So was, through you, Mr. President, was there any thought about the impact that it would have on other institutions like safety net hospitals, sure, such as St. Barnabas?
Sure. Through you, Mr. President, really the idea for this legislation, really the genesis of the legislation, was when myself and my colleague, Assemblyman Dinowitz, who also represents the same community, actually wrote a letter to the Department of Health asking why, if this proposed facility kind of looks like a hospital, feels like a hospital, is serving a large number of people like a hospital, why don't they have to go through the certificate of need process? And we received a very lengthy letter to say, if it's not considered a hospital, it's not a hospital, as simple as that. So I think requiring them to at least hear from the community is not only unduly burdensome. And as far as the concern you have about St. Barnabas, I spoke to Dr. Scott Cooper a couple days ago. I know he's planning on doing affordable housing and some other clinic, which I helped and supported him a couple years ago when that was actually within my Senate district. And I do not believe that it would be covered. First of all, what he's talking about is affordable housing. He's not talking about expanding a healthcare unit or providing any type of ambulatory care. But again, as I explained, we're not giving veto power to the local community. We're not allowing the local community board to just stop a project, but we are giving a voice to the local community and hoping and kind of mandating that the Department of Health at least hear the concerns of the community and then act accordingly.
Mr. President, if Senator Klein would continue to yield.
Senator Klein yields.
Yes, sir.
I have a particular question for you, Mr. President, on the language that says, I want to see if you could help me define what is supposed to, when it says that the Department of Health is supposed to consider, quote, the physical characteristics and social fabric of such community, unquote. What exactly does that mean, particularly the term social fabric? I'm not sure I understand what that means.
That would apply to what I said earlier. You know, a lot of times they would bring, sort of a ambulatory care center or something like this into a community, and they would need to identify really the need in the community. Who are you targeting? What population? You know, I think as economics go, I understand why Montefiore is proposing this. They rely very heavily on Medicaid dollars. I think they're the largest Medicaid recipient in the United States, and they're trying to tap into a market that is private pay and Medicare. Makes sense. But again, they should be able to have to show that there is a need for that type of facility here. I think that's probably the easiest burden or hurdle that any potential healthcare institution should have to meet. I think the more serious ones are the height, the density, the traffic, and things of that nature.
Through you, Mr. President, if the sponsor, if Senator Klein would yield.
Senator Klein, do you yield?
Yes, Mr. President.
Senator Rivera.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'd want to refer a second to line 30 on page 25. Reads as follows: after due consideration of the comments of the community forum and consultation with the education department, The commissioner shall either approve, modify, or deny authorization, et cetera. Is there any particular reason why the education department is in that language of the bill?
Yeah, because what this really is in the present characterization is really considered right now large doctor's offices. And as you know, that certification is done by the Department of Education.
Senator Klein, continue to yield.
Senator yields.
Yes.
So So it is something that's impacting, that it's going to impact one particular, in this case, impact that one particular institution. As it relates to what the Department of Health has to do, what kind of expertise of experience do they have in evaluating what the language of the bill is, quote, the appropriateness of the size, height, bulk, dimensions, and scope of such clinic, facility, or center when compared to the surrounding physical characteristics? I just want to know if the Department of Health would be able to perform this.
Well, remember something. You know, as I said, the genesis of this had to do with locally, zoning variances weren't changed, weren't met. So this project really would be known as an as-of-right project. That doesn't mean it's right. That doesn't mean that the institution shouldn't have to explain and answer those questions. But I think the key, Senator, is line 30 that you talked about before. After this entire process takes place, after this entire hearing takes place, after all of these questions are answered, the commissioner shall either approve, modify, or deny authorization for the establishment of any such clinic, facility, or center. So ultimately, the final hurdle, or the final decision, I should say, is made by the Department of Health.
Through you, Mr. President, if Senator Klein would yield for one more question.
Senator Klein, yield.
Yes, Mr. President.
Senator Rivera.
As far as the time and money that it would add to the process, if an institution wants to do something, put one of these up, either a freestanding clinic, outpatient healthcare facility, or ambulatory care center. As far as the time and the money that would be added to all the regulatory framework that they would have to undergo right now, has there been a consideration of what that would be?
Burden on who? The Department of Health or the
Through you, Mr. President,
project?
through the institution itself that is building one of these.
Well, again, I don't think it's too much of a burden or too much of an expense to require any health facility and their sponsor to actually show up at a hearing, talk about your plans. Remember, these hearings are being set by the Department of Health. It's just a matter of the sponsor showing up with diagrams, I guess, and everything else to explain to the community how this project will work. So I don't think it's much of a burden at all. And as a matter of fact, you know, moving forward, this is going to become an issue in other places. I think in some cases, you're going to see some of these places located in industrial parks, which are not near any communities. And you're probably not going to have community members or the community board even want a hearing. But I think more and more, when you see these really clinics or very large healthcare institutions that aren't considered hospitals in residential communities, you're going to see communities that are very, very concerned. Not necessarily that they oppose the healthcare institution, not necessarily that they may disagree with the whole concept, but I think they have a lot of questions, and I think the community, first and foremost, deserves answers.
One thing. If Senator Klein would.
For a final question, Senator Klein?
Yes, Mr. President.
Senator Rivera.
Thank you. Again, if it's this actually goes to the core of it. If it is such a good idea, why not impose it on the entire state? Why would you put it just for the Bronx? That's why I want to.
Genesis of this legislation came out of, you know, a community concern. As you know, Senator, 38% of the people employed in Bronx County employed in the healthcare profession. This is something that means jobs. But I think also, when you're building these large facilities, I really don't think it's too much to ask that the local community, in the sake of a community board or other interested parties, get their say. And I think that's going to make for a better facility. I think it's going to be made really cause better planning. and really, I think, really better PR where the communities will hear. This came out of, as I said, a very, very large proposal. It's 11 stories that they're proposing. Didn't contact anyone, didn't contact the local community board. No one really knew what they were even building there until finally someone found out and they had a big rally. So I think this will prevent that. This will cause these proposals or these sponsors to be good neighbors, understand that they're locating in a community, understanding that this will be their future client base, and they should respect their wishes. And I think this is something that really needs to be done statewide eventually. And I thought it was important that in the Bronx, especially as it involves this project, the pilot program be in Bronx County, and see how it works for the rest of this, see how it works here if we want to follow through with the rest of the state.